obviously you don't go down the wrong path if you don't have to. But if it came down to it, I would sell crack to your kids so I could buy...
Trouble on my mind, refuse to lose. Here's your ticket. Hit a drummer, get wicked. The crew to you to push the back, the black attack. So I sat and chapped and slapped the Mac. Now ready to mic it. Hear my favorite tunes and Rolo. Never be a brother like me, go solo. Blazer, Anastasia, major. Ways to blaze your brain and train ya. The way I'm living, forgiving what I'm giving up. X on the flex, hear me now. As for now, I know how to avoid the paranoid. Man, I've had it up to here. Yeah, how weird, got him going in fear. Rhetoric said and read just a bit ago. Not quitting the sign of hard rhymer. Work to keep from getting jerk changes some ways. So way back in the better days. Raw, metaphysically bold. Never follow the code. Still trust the Lord.
Honestly, just a little insight. You probably could tell it's quite a neat and tight. It's killing me that these records are out. Like, I know we've got to do other stuff today, and you're just saying that, take them down, put them aside, put them change. I want to put these back.
Yes.
Good stuff, man.
Like, from that shop?
From a shop, yeah.
£50 pounders.
Like, for example, you know, you've got a vinyl, okay, and you... Right, if you've got records at home, just try this, okay? Take the record out, and with the sleeve there, okay, right? Just put that to the side, because you can download that on MP3 anyway, right? But the cover itself... Now, yeah, look, if you take the cover here, yeah, you could just make that into a hat. And you can have, you know, you can have a different hat for every day of the week.
Certain things that are about Swindon that, like, I can guarantee you, yeah, that everyone who's got a record collection over 1,000, yeah, has a copy of Bushkiller. And that's like a Swindon anthem. It's like, it there's no two ways about it. It's like, if you're into hip-hop and you've got a record collection, you've got Bushkiller.
I must cause quakes in the dark, cause niggas say, hey, there's that walk who escaped Jurassic Park. Pure panics gets the crowd manic. Step, if you want star stags, check it. Billy grabs a crossfader, black steel's bloody straight from torture chamber. Ditch bludgeons and I bury, I smash your crew, ditch, I don't need your backup.
Well, yeah, that record went today. That some guy came in and took it, and they were like, who took that? Who would be interested in that? Who'd want that? And the guy is this guy. I'm just known as this guy from Swindon. That's what I'm known as. I'm known as that guy from Swindon came down and took it.
Can't avoid the internet for digging now.
eBay can be really good. I mean, some people knock eBay, but eBay's really good for picking up records that are super hard to find.
Like these old dudes, these old farts, man. I mean, I'm an old fart myself, and they're like, oh, you can't go on fucking eBay and start paying for records and picking up records off eBay.
In your town or country, you get records from all over the world, and often you can get them a lot cheaper than you would, you know, if you went to a record shop or whatever. So yeah, definitely worth checking eBay.
Look, at the end of the fucking day, if it was there when they were fucking doing it, they'd be on it. It's like you've got to embrace every fucking thing you can to fucking loot vinyl completely.
I've never really looked up rare records and bought them on eBay. Never did that. Never looked up rare breaks or anything like that.
If you want to win, you've got to go on eBay. There's no two fucking ways about it.
That's the last record I brought.
Wrestling Rocks. Real Rock and Roll, as sung by the world's greatest professional wrestlers.
Found that in the charity shop. For fucking... I've got 20 pence, man.
Locomotive GT. It's got that B-boy break, Rock Yourself on it. And then Steppenwolf Slow Flux.
This fucking Raw Task Force strategy.
I'd say the majority of my collection is hip hop, funk, jazz, reggae, sort of psychedelic rock.
The library records, like I said before, collecting soundtracks.
Rock, breaks, bit of jazz, bit of blues.
I'm fucking prog and UK hip hop, like golden era, like hard to find, white label, you know, UK hip hop.
Yes.
My last 3, 4, 5 record shop missions, I spent 700 to a grand, like, at a time.
Yeah, the money's it's quite harsh, but if you've got money, you can buy records. If you ain't got money, you just lay off for a while.
I bought records today. I bought records yesterday. But I bought records the day before that.
I'm not addicted to this, I'm addicted to what's on it.
Recently I've been back in the charity bins again, you know, because it got a little bit too much.
I will admit, it's got to the point now where, you know, you're collecting them.
I did buy records on the weekend. So yeah, you go through phases, but I wouldn't stop. I don't know. It's definitely, I'm put it this way, I'm as addicted to buying records as most of my mates are. You can't go onto iTunes and get The Clear Way to Skin Health read by Bob Monkhouse.
MP3s, they're not physically there, are they?
Nothing there, what's the point in, you know, getting an MP3, it's just a trick, isn't it? It's an illusion.
The Romantic, Stuart Giles. See? You don't get those haircuts on your MP3s.
They fucking suck, man, they're shit. Who wants one? No one wants one. You ever tried flogging an MP3 to someone? You ever seen an MP3 go for 2 grand? You know, Have you ever seen someone fucking losing their wife and kids over an MP3?
I started getting into digging breaks, and at the start I was just going to charity shops, where I spend most of the time anyway. My time still is in charity shops digging for, like, you know, crappy breaks and stuff.
A lot of it is more about the hunt than the actual... It's all about the hunt and the kill, rather than once it goes in the crates. Yeah, if you're using it for DJing or using it to play out, then that's cool. But a lot of the time you're after a record, and then when you get it, it's like, yeah, I got it, and you put it back. So
I just had a call from my mum, who's got a day off, and she's suggesting that we take my little boy on a train. So, which is cool, but I'm always thinking, right, where can I go where I can also check out a record shop or go through charity shops or dig?
That's what it's worth. It's, you know, you pay for the enjoyment and fun and the hunt, and, you know, at the end of the day, you've got something to show for it, you know, and it's not just a photograph. That's basically the way I see it. It's just the time and effort. That's what it's worth.
I'm definitely addicted to that pursuit of going out and finding the records.
You go into a record shop, there's a record on the wall, say, for £40. It's probably worth £40, depending on the condition. You could probably haggle it down maybe to 30, so maybe the 25 you're pushing you that. But, you know, generally, it's kind of, the prices are set, and they're usually pretty fair in the shops.
I got lucky, actually, when we were away. I managed to pick up, like, a few library records, like, ridiculously cheap. And that kind of got me interested in it, really.
I've done it to you, I've done it to pretty much everyone in Swindon, especially on Sundays at car boot sales. I'll make sure I ring people just as I'm arriving to check they're not there. And then I let them, yeah, I say, yeah, I'm in the other one. So they don't go there either. So then I can go that one and then go to the other one. Yeah.
You start bringing home wedges and wedges of records from car boots and stuff, getting up at the crack of dawn and doing all that, and then you realise, like, well, how many kicks, hi-hats and snares, how many different orders do I want them in on records?
Can't think. I don't know if any on this wall has been found in a charity shop. No.
Basically, if you're out and about, then you go somewhere different, then you'll try and find somewhere that sells records.
Different countries, different places, small outback places in the UK that you wouldn't go to. And this is how I got most of my records, is in the back, touring for the last 2 or 3 years.
You could go on eBay and get it for a quid tomorrow, but that's not the point, you know. It's about the weeks and weeks of going into town on the cold, frosty mornings, spending hours, knees on the floor, hand in the grime, literally smelling the sweat of 50 old men. And just, you know, to come out with something that, yeah, you could probably pick up on the internet for pence, but it's part of the fun.
This is in the book now for about, I don't know, 500, but the last, like, good copy of this went online for over a grand.
I'm not going to polish it up. I am skint to the fucking bone. And I ain't bothered about it, you know. It's like, that's not cool, you know, to be fucking skint. So, you know, if people collect records because they think that it's cool, they're fucking lying to themselves.
To be fair, record collecting is extreme behaviour. I'm happy to admit that. The more and more you get into collecting records, the more you search for records, the more you realise that there is no end. There's no end. Like now, when I was younger, I was picking stuff up and I was like, oh yeah, you know, no, you know, getting into this music. Now it's got to the stage where, you know, got more and more into records through DJing and stuff. And the more you start to find out, the more you realise you haven't got a clue. There is literally a never-ending world of interest in records and music and different genres from around the world, and like all sorts of crazy things that were pressed up. Because you've got to remember, at one stage, records, that was the only way you were getting your music or your sounds or whatever it was. That was the only way you were getting it out. So everyone was pressing up records, from the smallest private press labels to massive companies. So there's just so much great music out there, so many crazy records, that now I look at my collection of stuff, I think I haven't even scraped the surface. I've got no knowledge whatsoever, you know. So that's what's exciting about buying records, is that, you know, every day you pick something up and you find out something else, and you might just hear one thing and you look at the back and you see the artist and you think, yeah, now I'm going to find out more about this artist, which is going to then find out more about this artist. And so, yeah, that's one of the most exciting things for me about getting records, is just constantly finding out about new stuff. The Don, why not let everyone know about it? You like hot dogs? You like hanging out on the beach? Self-explanatory, really. It's disco music for people who like hot dogs.